Oh, you know, I'm not angry. I'm not. I promise I'm not angry. What I really am is just 100% disappointed. Quantum TV, you just couldn't let it go, could you? Here we go. So what has Quantum TV done this time? Well, that's the new slogan going around YouTube nowadays, and the fact that Quantum TV videos are taking off like a skyrocket in the algorithm, might as well go ahead and do a double take on this guy. But you see, it's not unwarranted. Quantum has unfortunately made a few videos on a couple of people, two of them being one from Griffin Gaming, which he actually just took down recently, and the other on Rich of ReviewTech USA. Now, what we're gonna focus on today is on Rich, because this one, this one, ladies and gentlemen, this one is an absolute thigh slapper, and you're gonna be ready for this because Quantum is in a whole heap of trouble.
So, I'm really sick and tired of these Elden Ring fans every day, most recently 2 minutes ago, talking about where's your Elden Ring videos. Link your Elden Ring review. I heard you'd lose chromosomes, which frankly would probably make you smarter or something. If I'm reading this right, you don't want to have too many chromosomes, but
18 seconds into this man's video, and we're already here. This is where we are. This is how we've begun, Quantum TV. This is where you're going to start, is a chromosome joke. Can this really get much worse than this? You ask yourselves? It absolutely can.
You know, it is what it is. I mean, everything that I'm seeing right now is about Elden Ring, and they want to try to drag other shit into it, talking about he's a bigot, he's a false copyright striker, but this is about Elden Ring, make no mistake.
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
Now you see, you're the one making the mistake here. Elden Ring has never been the issue. Elden Ring was in fact the catalyst to the real issue of Quantum TV. See, that's what began this whole thing. If all you did was leave Mischief's channel alone and not falsely try to strike his channel, none of this would be happening to you. None of it. None of it at all. It would all be gone. You would be irrelevant once again. No one would care about you. This video wouldn't be made about you. But you can't let it go. You can't just take your L and walk away. So we're here again.
A YouTuber by the name of Mischief. Now, I would never have even known who the hell he was if it wasn't for the YouTube content ID tool literally flagging his video for using a certain percentage of my video, because that's how the damn tool works. And so I literally reached out to him, told him to take that shit down. Eventually, he took it down because he, quotation mark, didn't want to deal with it.
But oh, man. The gaslighting doesn't end. Does it, Quantum? The gaslighting for you and gasoline and a light and a flame are like just one and the same. You literally, in your own words that you typed out, which I'm displaying on screen right now, told Mischief that if he doesn't remake the video, you are going to strike his channel. Of course he took the video down. You threatened a copyright strike on his channel, on his video, which was 100% fair use. You are a false copyright flagger, and you will continue to be that. And that, my friend, is the entire reason why everyone is at your throat. How you don't understand this is beyond comprehension, and you still go back to Elden Ring. But ladies and gentlemen, it gets worse. Still.
And it's at the point now where it's annoying. And more annoying is how it's devolved into something personal, because seeing that I'm not backing down from this Elden Ring bullshit, now they want to start getting even more personal. So let's take it there. Let's look at ReviewTech USA. He's a large channel, but he's really obsessive. He just continues making videos about me, using my face and my thumbnail to try to slander and cancel me at every stretch of the imagination. Now, this wouldn't be a big problem if he didn't have over 900,000 plus subscribers.
You used to give me such a wallop. Right, Bert? Remember that? Bert, remember how hard you would hit me?
As hard as I could. As long as I could. Frankly, all the hitting drained me. I had to go to the hospital and have my hands replaced. I was too high, too out of my mind.
First of all, my boy, what is up with the audio in that clip? We went from full stereo to mono on one side and then back to full stereo. That is not how audio should work in a video. Secondly, we are now seeing the real reason why you're upset at Review Tech USA. You're not upset that he criticized you. You're not upset that other people criticized you. You're upset at his sub count and his view count. That's why you're mad. The fact that he has a larger user base than you do, and the fact that you can't just sit there and say, well, it's a smaller channel, it's not gonna get enough traction, I don't gotta worry about it. However, Review Tech USA has almost 1 million subs. That is undeniable. Now you can't turn around on that, and you can't walk back from that. Instead of just taking your L gracefully and saying, I messed up, whatever, and being gone and ignored the whole time, you continually come back and do this again. But see, you're the one digging your own grave. It's funny to watch you, though. I'm not gonna lie.
But much like Onision, Rich from Review Tech USA is a pedophile and...
How did we get here? How did you even come to this conclusion? Oh boy. No. We're not doing this. You need to have some real strong evidence to make this kind of claim, or else that's literally slander. No, though, literally, if you don't have true, actual evidence to prove this, it's slander. That's a problem. And it better not be like some really shitty tweet.
But he wants to run with cancel culture. He wants to literally try to cancel me for hacked tweets. Yes, you heard that right. Hacked tweets, as if I'm special. That's right, folks. I'm the only one on social media, period, that has ever been hacked.
It's not personal, but you are an abortion.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. Oh, that wasn't me. I didn't do it. It wasn't me. I was hacked. Oh, I was hacked in 2018. I was hacked. You mean how in 2018, separate months apart, you were hacked each individual time? You said things like this, and this, and then this, and this. But then when you were getting your account back, you didn't go back and delete the tweets that were hacked, did you? Oh, but hey, look, in 2020, you said stuff like this, and this, and this. Weird. Were you hacked every single time? Huh. Wild. So at this moment in time, Quantum TV decides to dig up the one, I would say, major flaw that Rich has had in his past, and that is where he decides to use the gamer word, not that one, the other one, on a Periscope livestream against one of his trolls. Granted, Rich has also apologized for this immediately afterwards and has taken ownership of it, something that Quantum TV literally has not done. But yet, remember those posts I made earlier? Here's what Quantum thinks about Rich's little flub.
You will never, in 1 million years, hear me saying any horrible things like that, right? But I think it's funny. I think it's really funny that this is the same fucking guy that comes out and is like, oh, these are horrible fucking people. It's like he does the reverse. It's like his opposite day of how he actually is as a human being in real life.
Honey, you've got a big storm coming.
You know, when you go in the dictionary and you look up the term hypocrite, you're going to find Quantum TV. Because literally, the things that Quantum TV is blaming Rich or Review Tech USA for are the exact same things that Quantum has done. And you can't hide behind the whole I was hacked in 2018, when there are posts that I've shown clearly that are not on Twitter, on other social media platforms, of you saying one thing and then acting another way.
Remember this, Rich? You say, I'm gonna say it. I'm a fan of Vosh V. Deal with it. See, when you say you're a fan of somebody, that means I like their work, I like their content, I like their values, I like what they stand for, I like this person, right?
Shut up, bitch! Oh my God!
So here it is. This is your grand connection. This is how you pulled everything together. A simple tweet, which I called out before, about him saying Rich likes Vosh V. Personally, I don't like Vosh. I think he's an absolute grifter. I don't agree with him at all. And I think that the things he says are false equivalences. And what he tries to do is just say things that are controversial to then grift people out of their money. That being said, however, you can be a fan of someone and still disagree with a lot of their major points. You can be a fan of Lovecraftian horror, but then dislike H.P. Lovecraft because of his racist connotations. You can be a fan of Harry Potter, but then dislike J.K. Rowling because of her actual opinions. You see, you can be a fan of something, and you can go from their content and their work, and then you can stop at their morals and values. You're conflating the two, and it doesn't make any sense. That's not how a fan of things works. You can be a fan of something and disagree with them entirely. Just because you're a fan of someone doesn't mean everything they say and everything they do is infallible and you take completely and entirely.
I'm the bigot, I'm the crazy. You know, you see what Quantum gets? This is what I get for not liking a game, for YouTube copyright ID tool, you know, finding this little smaller YouTuber and flagging him, right? He being a little fuck that likes to take people's video and use them and talk about them and say whatever they want and using too much of it and then tripping up an algorithm. And I fucking use the tool the way it's supposed to be used. I'm a abuser. I'm all this shit. You see what I mean?
Our plan has come to fruition. Now we can finally collect unemployment. Thanks, Obama.
First of all, talking about yourself in the third person. What are you? What is this, like a Seinfeld episode? Am I in fucking Bizarro World right now? Second of all, you can use the YouTube algorithm to actually go ahead and copyright people, but the thing is, you shouldn't. That's the problem. The thing is, you don't understand fair use. That's where all of this comes from. If you would have just gone ahead and clicked the video and then clicked archive in the copyright tab, none of this would have ever happened to you. But here you are, being a clown, the lull cow to be milked, continuously, never ending. It's gonna keep going. You're gonna make more videos, and I'm gonna have to keep getting views on you. Because you're a clown. That's what you are. Welcome to the show, honk honk.
Which kind of makes me wonder, maybe that's why you don't have a ring on your finger. Maybe that's why your kids aren't around you. Maybe that's why your baby mama went so far out of that picture that, like, all you get are visitation rights at best, right? Because maybe there's something wrong with you. Because you're not worth speaking up for at the end of the day. Because there's something fundamentally in your character that you don't show publicly all the time, but occasionally slip up on tweets.
This extraordinary creature is half blind, half deaf, and this is just about as fast as it can move.
My dude, my guy, my boy, how are you not self-aware? I'm struggling to find that answer. How you are unable to be self-aware in all of this, in any of this, in like the microscopic iota of this. This is how you act. This is how you are. I've proven it throughout this whole video, and this, oh God, this is how you end the whole concept. I can't, I won't, I cannot, I will cease. You, oh my God, you know what? Done. I'm done. I'm gonna leave it here, and this is gonna be the ending, because you clearly are so inept in your own mind, and you're so self-absorbed, you cannot clearly comprehend the actual facet of you projecting yourself onto this person. Enough. Done. Peace.
I don't have to lie about shit. If I want to say some shit, I'll let you know it. If you don't know my personality, I'm very blunt. I'll say what's on my mind. And if that was really my character, you would have seen a track record of it being my fucking character. And you haven't. The reality is, it is what it is. I got hacked in 2018, and everything you find from 2018 is just that. It's a fucking hack.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a man who is incapable of being able to take his own L directly and just sitting quietly, going back to his own community and just living there completely. This is truly an insane person, which has been on the internet for honestly far too long, has had his own track record show that he's not only been hacked in 2018, but then again in 2020, and then again recently as well. But you know what? Hey, we'll let the evidence speak for itself. And unfortunately, his projection does not end in this video. But hey, if you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. We're getting close to 23,000 subscribers, and I want to say thank you very much. You can check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It is at Oh No It's Alex. You can also join the Discord. The link to that is in the description down below. Anyways, y'all, thank you so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.
Son of a bitch! Bullshit, Joe Hogan!